Hello everyone, I am Dr. Saravanan, final year PG, AVMC, Pondicherry. My paper presentation topic is CT evaluation of acute pancreatitis and its prognostic correlation with the CT-CRT index. My co-author is Dr. Professor Nitish. Acute pancreatitis is a common condition presenting the acute abdomen. It is broadly classified into two subtypes. One is edematous or mild acute pancreatitis, and second one is necrotizing or severe acute pancreatitis. Common causes of pancreatitis are cholecystitis and ethanol abuse. CT imaging features of acute pancreatitis include focal or diffuse enlargement of the pancreas with peripancreatic fat standing and peripancreatic visual thickening and fluid fractions. Balthasar introduced a grading system for acute pancreatitis based on an overall assessment of size, contour, and density of the gland with peripancreatic abnormalities to predict the severity of the disease. The aim of the study is to assess the prognostic correlation of the patient outcomes with the accepted Balthasar and the modified model CT-CVRT indices in acute pancreatitis. It was a prospective study conducted from November 2020 to November 2021 in a Department of Early Diagnosis, AVMC. Total of 30 patients referred from Department of Emergency Medicine and Surgery in AVMC with the chief complaints of epigastric pain, nausea, and vomiting. A CECT was suggested of acute pancreatitis were included in the study. Patients who are clinically suspected of acute pancreatitis of all ages were included, whereas patients with chronic pancreatitis history and other pancreatic pathologies or any previous pancreatic surgery or postoperative cases were excluded. The study group consisted of 19 male patients and 11 female patients. Length of the hospital stay, need for surgery or percutaneous intervention, evidence of infection in any organ systems, any organ failures, system failures, and patient discharged or patient death as the clinical outcomes compared with the currently accepted Balthasar and modified model severity indexes in all the cases. Here, this is the Balthasar grading system of acute pancreatitis for pancreatic parenchyma and necrosis. And here we see modified CT-CVRT index gradings for pancreatic inflammation, pancreatic necrosis. Here, in more than 30% of pancreatic parenchyma is necrosed, the patient is given 4 points. As compared with the Balthasar grading system, 30 to 50% are given 4 points, and more than 50 is given 6 points. And extra pancreatic complications are given 2 points. Mild pancreatitis was when points were 0 to 2, and when points were between 4 to 6, it was given moderate. When it is between 8 to 10, it is severe pancreatitis. Here, these are the images taken during the study. The first image shows bulky pancreas with heterogeneous enlargement and with mild ascites. Here, modified CT-CVRT index and Balthasar scores are poor, suggestive of moderate pancreatitis. The first image shows bulky heterogeneous pancreas with peripancreatic fat standing and few necrotic areas seen within the pancreas, which are less than 30%. And minimal pleural, bilateral pleural connection, basal subsegmental atelectasis were seen in second image. Balthasar score was 6 and modified CT severity score was 8. Suggestive of intermediate and severe pancreatitis respectively. Here the first image was diffusely edematous pancreas with peripancreatic fat standing and fluid collections with very nephric facial thickening. And the second image shows bilateral pleural effusion and basal subsegmental atelectasis. Here the Balthasar score was 5 and CT modified CT CVRT index score was 6, suggestive of intermediate and moderate pancreatitis respectively. The first image shows acute necrotizing pancreatitis affecting more than 50%, and second image shows acute necrotizing pancreatitis with a peripancreatic fluid collection. Here both the scores were thin and suggests of severe pancreatitis. These are the patients with acute necrotizing pancreatitis with more than 50% of pancreatic parenchyma involved. And both the scores were thin, suggest of severe pancreatitis. Here the first image shows vein thrombosis, and the second image shows gangrenous pancreatitis with a air poking inside. Here the symptoms and signs in the patients of acute pancreatitis were epigastric pain, nausea, or vomiting in 75% of the patients. Most common CT findings were peripancreatic inflammatory changes in mesentery. Second most common CT finding were pancreatic contour irregularity. Gallstone was the most common etiological factor, and alcohol was the most common, second most common etiological factor seen only in males. These are the charts representing the etiology of acute pancreatitis and grading severity of acute pancreatitis using Balthasar and modified mortal CRT indexes. The most common CT findings observed in the series are peripancreatic inflammatory changes. 26 patients had this finding. Parenchymal changes in the pancreas, including diffuse or focal enlargement of the pancreas in the 18 patients, contour irregularity in 24, and non-homogeneous attenuation of pancreas in 20 patients. The most common extra pancreatic complication in this group was pleural effusion, and left side was more common. In the study, when Balthasar CT severity index was used, it was graded as a mild in 13 patients, moderate in 7, and severe in 10 patients. In contrast, when a modified CT severity index was used, it was graded as a 13 as severe and 6 as mild and 11 as moderate. It was observed in our study that no significant association exists in different subgroups of necrosis when using the Balthasar, whereas modified CT severity score index correctly predicted the outcome in all the patients who had a shift in their severity grades than Balthasar CT severity index. CECT was found to be an excellent imaging modality for diagnosis, establishing the extent of the disease process or the grading. Modified CT severity index is a simpler scoring tool and more accurate than a Balthasar. In this study, it has a stronger statistical correlation with the clinical outcome. It could also predict the need for the interventional procedures. These are my references. Thank you.